Welcome back to my channel where math is made easy. So today we're going to be looking at solving systems of equations, specifically by using the elimination method. In my last video, I looked at solving systems of equations by using substitution. I'll put that link in the description section. All right, now remember to go over, like, share this video and comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Now let's dive right into it. So when we are using the elimination method, as the name suggests, you're gonna find one of the variables that you can get rid of. Now in order to do that, the coefficient of those variables must be the same. All right, now if we look at example one, both variables have their coefficients being the same or being its opposite, which is okay. So it means that we can eliminate either the x or the y in this case. Now I'm going to be eliminating the x. Now in order to eliminate it, you'll have to add or subtract equation 2 from equation 1. Now how do we decide if we're adding or subtracting? You decide by looking which one of the operation will make this become 0. All right, in my case, use a different color right here. In my case, I'll have to subtract because I'm trying to get rid of the x. So 3x minus 3x is gonna give me a 0. Now let's move to the next part, because remember it's the entire equation that we're subtracting. A negative times a negative, and let me put that right there, is gonna give me a positive, and that's something that we must remember. So my 2y right here is going to become a plus 2y. So now I have 2y plus 2y is equal to 4y. And again, a negative times a negative right here is going to make this become a plus. So that's 4 plus 4 equals 8. Now that we have that, we can go ahead and solve for y. This is 4 times y. So to undo my 4, I will have to divide by 4, and anything I do on one side, I do to the next. So y is equal to 2. Now, like with the substitution method, now that I have my y, I can go ahead and substitute y equals 2 in any one of the equations to find my x. I'm going to choose to substitute it in equation 1. So sub y equals 2 in equation 1. Let me just write these there so you know what you're actually doing. So that's equation 1, and that's equation 2. All right, so let's plug that in. So that's 3x plus 2y equals 4. And remember now, anywhere I see y, I'm going to put 2. So that's 3x plus 2, bracket 2 equals 4. 3x plus 4 equals 4. I need to get rid of that 4, so that's going to be a minus to undo it. I'm sorry, this should be 4 right here, right? I'm going ahead of myself. So this is equal to 0, and that's also equal to 0. So I'm left with 3x equals 0, so I'm going to get rid of my 3, and that means my x is equal to 0. So let's write the solution. So the solution is x is equal to 0 and my y is equal to 2. Remember that the solution is any pair that makes your equation true. So when I plug x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 2, my equation should be true. All right, good. Now let's look at example 2. Example 2, if you notice, none of my coefficients are the same. So my coefficients for the x are not the same. My coefficients for the y's not the same. So it means that we'll have to do a little bit more work. Very easy still, but we'll have to put a little bit more in it. So we'll have to get one of them to have the same coefficient. I could choose to make this 6 or make this 10. Whatever way you choose. Well, I'm going to choose this. So in order to get this to become the same coefficient or the opposite coefficient, it means that I'll have to multiply this entire equation by 2. All right, so that's 2 times 5, and I'm going to rewrite my new equation right here. That's 2 times negative 5, that's negative 10x. 2 times negative 6, that's negative 12y. Equals 2 times 23, that's 46. All right, I'm going to go ahead now, and I'm going to use the elimination method as we did over here. So let's rewrite my equation 1, that's negative 10x plus 3y equals 1. And I'm going to write my new equation 2, that's negative 10x minus 12y equals 46. So let's go ahead and eliminate. Now, which operation would we need to use to eliminate the x's? If you said minus, then you're correct. Why? Because again, a minus times a minus is going to give me a positive. So it means that now this is going to become a plus 10x, and a negative 10x plus 10x is going to give me 0. All right, remember that's our aim. Now this is negative times negative 12 is equal to, that's going to be a positive 12. So I'm just going to put that right there just to help you to remember. All right, so that's now 3x plus 12y equals 15y. And remember, this is now a negative times a positive. So let me put this right here. Negative times a positive is equal to a negative. All right, so that's a negative times a positive 46. That's now going to give me a negative right there. All right, so 1 minus 46 is equal to negative 45. Now that we have that, we can go ahead and solve for y. So we're going to go and divide through both sides by 15. Y is equal to, so let's divide through right here. So that's 15 into itself, 1, 15 into 45, that's negative 3. So now we have y is equal to negative 3. We can go ahead and substitute that in any one of the equations, but I'm going to choose equation 1 again. So solve y equals negative 3 in equation 1. What's equation 1? 10x plus 3x equals 1. All right? So let's use another color right here. Remember, anywhere I see y, let's rewrite this. Sorry. So that's 10x, sorry, plus 3y equals 1. All right, now that we have that fixed, we can go ahead. We're going to change the color so that we can see clearly. So that's negative 10x plus 3, and anywhere I see y, I'm going to put negative 3 equals 1. That's negative 10x plus, sorry, that would be a minus. That's going to be a minus 9, because a positive times a negative is going to give me a minus, right? So that's now a plus 9 right there. And anything you do on one side, you do to the next. We're trying to get rid of the 9. So that's negative 10x equals plus 10. What's my next move? Let's use another color. We're going to divide through by negative 10. All right, so that's canceled out. That's canceled out. I am now with a negative 1. So my x is equal to negative 1. Let's write our solution. So that's x equals negative 1, and my y equals negative 3. Remember, your solution is any pair that makes the equation true. So if I'm to plug negative x here and negative 3 right there, I should get negative 1. All right, thank you for watching. I hope this would have helped you. I'll see you in our next video.